Hello and welcome to the latest ACS travel restrictions news. As ever, global travel rules and restrictions continue to change this week. The UK has announced a three-tier system of local lockdown measures in an attempt to curb rising COVID-19 rates, with regions categorised as medium, high and very high depending on local infection rates. The Greek islands of Seriphus, Santorini, Lesbos, Zakynthos and Tinos have been added to the nation's no quarantine travel corridor, meaning Mykonos and Crete are now the only Greek islands on the UK's quarantine list. Italy is also expected to introduce new restrictions later this week, after the country's daily infection rate surpassed 5,000 for the first time since March. Travellers from the UK, Czech Republic, Netherlands and Belgium must now provide a negative COVID-19 test taken no more than 72 hours prior to arrival, but this restriction no longer applies to visitors from Greece and Malta. European Union countries are expected to introduce guidelines that coordinate their COVID-19 measures in a bid to make travel within the bloc smoother. The Spanish government is moving to establish travel corridors between European countries and the Canary and Balearic Islands, tourism hubs that have been badly affected by the COVID-19 pandemic. Meanwhile, Finland has removed all EU Schengen nations apart from the Vatican City from its no quarantine list. Norway has done the same for Latvia, Liechtenstein, Cyprus and areas of Sweden, and Switzerland has followed suit for Canada, Georgia, Tunisia, Slovenia and areas of Germany. In the Netherlands, the government advises against non-essential travel to Amsterdam, The Hague and Rotterdam. Visitors from abroad no longer need to book their accommodation before travelling. In Russia, a third of office workers must remain at home in Moscow following a rise in the number of new cases. In North America, US officials hope to open travel between New York City and London with shortened quarantine periods. Canada has tightened local restrictions, announcing regional lockdowns in Toronto with restaurants and bars closed and people asked to remain at home unless travelling to work. Costa Rica has begun welcoming US citizens who live in Florida, Georgia and Texas on flights from the United States, with all US citizen tourists welcome from the 1st of November. Australia is in discussions with several countries about quarantine-free travel, with hopes of finalising an agreement with New Zealand by December, followed by similar arrangements with Japan, Singapore, South Korea and Pacific Island nations in 2021. Travel to high-risk areas like the USA and Europe looks unlikely until late 2021. New Zealand currently allows Australian citizens, residents and their immediate family to transit if they don't leave the airport. Anyone entering the country must quarantine in a government facility for 14 days. From the 16th of October, New Zealanders can travel to the Australian states of New South Wales, Canberra and the Northern Territory without quarantining on arrival, but must self-isolate in a hotel following their return. Elsewhere in the APAC region, Malaysia has introduced new restrictions in the capital city of Kuala Lumpur and neighbouring Selangor following a surge in COVID-19 cases, while Singapore and Indonesia have announced a reciprocal green lane enabling citizens to cross the border for essential business and official travel from the 26th of October. Passengers must have proof of a negative COVID-19 test taken no more than 7 days before their arrival. Japan hopes to reinstate tourism in April 2021 ahead of the rescheduled Tokyo Olympic Games. In the meantime, citizens and residents returning from business trips abroad are now exempt from the country's 14-day self-isolation rule if they provide proof of a negative COVID-19 test taken no more than 72 hours before their return flight departed. The East African country of Madagascar restarts flights this month, with strict guidelines in place to prevent the spread of COVID-19. Passengers must test negative for coronavirus 48 hours before boarding domestic flights. South Africa reopened its borders to international commercial air travel on the 1st of October. The country has classified the UK as high risk, with tourism and leisure travel from the nation prohibited. Business travellers must secure permission before flying to South Africa from the UK. Elsewhere in the MEIA region, UAE nationals no longer have to take a COVID-19 test before boarding an aircraft home, but travel rules for Dubai residents to and from other Emirates is unchanged. If you can travel, please stay safe, and we will see you next week for a new travel news report.